हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, वी हैव डिड सम प्रॉब्लम्स, वी हैव सॉल्वड सम प्रॉब्लम्स इन एक्सरसाइज वन, दैट इज फर्स्ट बीट एंड सेकेंड बीट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड। नाउ वी विल बी सॉल्विंग वन मोर क्वेश्चन। ओके, वन मोर क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री। सो हियर इन क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री व्हाट ही हैड गिवन, यूज अ डिविजन एल्गोरिथम टू show that the square of any positive integer is of form 3p, 3p plus 1. So till now what we have did the questions on positive integers which are in odd and even form. Okay, so we just discussed about odd and even number of questions. So now we are going to discuss the question on squares and cubes. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the question which is depending upon square in division algorithm. Okay, now so coming to the question, here we have to use the Euclid's division algorithm to show square of any positive integer. So any positive integer, for that if we are doing square, it means that if we are multiplying that two times, then it will be getting in the form of 3p and 3p plus 1. That thing we have to show in this question. Okay, so now as I have told you, for solution what you have to do, you have to use five steps. So first, what he had given positive integer, isn't it? So do we know that positive integer? We don't know that positive integer. So let a be any positive integer that a be any positive integer. Why we are taking a only? Why? Because these forms are taken in a. So here divisor will be 3, isn't it? So the integer which is divisible is taken in a form of a, which is being represented in this form should be taken in a. So let a be any positive integers. Okay, let a be any positive integer. What we need to do? We need to show that square of any positive integer is either in the form of 3p or in the form of 3p plus 1, is in form 3p or 3p plus 1, where p is some integer. So this thing we have to show here. So now from Euclid's, we have to prove from division algorithm. So from Euclid's division lemma, what do we know a equals to b cube plus r, where 0 less than equals to r less than b. This condition is very, very important. That is, the remainder value is from 0 to b less than b. Okay, isn't it? So now you can see here, before coefficient value, what we have here, the divisor is 3, isn't it? The divisor is 3. So therefore, at b is equals to 3, okay, at b is equals to 3, then what I will get? A is equals to 3q plus r, where 0 less than equals to r less than b value, that is 3. It means that the remainder value is from 0 to less than 3. So r value is 0, 1, 2. That's it. Okay, we can't take the value as 3. The remainder value is less than 3. So less than 3 are 0, 1 and 2 positive integers, isn't it? So now here we'll be getting three cases, isn't it? So from case one, in case number one, we have a is equals to 3q plus r. So we'll be having 3q plus r here. So in the place of r, substitute r is equals to 0, isn't it? So up to 2 we have to use here. r value, isn't it? Now I have to substitute a is equals to 3q plus 0. I will be getting a is equals to 3q. Now let me remember you what he had asked in the question. He discussed about the square of any positive integer. So here I have positive integer, but what about he asked? He asked about square, isn't it? If he asked about square, what is the square of this integer? A square, isn't it? So for making these integer in square form, what we want to do? We want to square on both sides, squaring on both sides. Why we are squaring on both sides? In question we have square of any positive integer, that any positive integer is a. So what is the square of that a? It will become a square. Here as we have only a, we have to convert it into square form, that is in a square form. So because of that reason, I am squaring in both sides, squaring on both sides. So what it become? A square is equals to 3q whole square, isn't it? So if I multiply these 3 square, it means 3 into 3. So 3 into 3 into q square. Am I right or wrong? So if I take 3 common here, if I take 3 common outside, in the bracket, I will be getting 3q square. You can see here, 3 threes are, again it will become 3 square, that is 9. Am I right or wrong? So here, behalf of 3, extra value do you have? What the value you have, such value here, I am writing that 3q square in a form of m, no, p. P. Why? He asked the value in a form of p, because of that reason, this alphabetical value except 3, why? The value of b is 3, isn't it? So it is divisible by, so that 3 I have to taken, I have to take outside. So here I have taken 3 outside. So behalf of, okay, with 3, including with 3, what do I have that I will be taking in the alphabet which I have in the question? So that is p. So this 3q square I have written in a form of p. So what it becomes? 3p, isn't it? Now you can see a square we got as 3p, isn't it? Square of positive integer is in the form of 3p. Similarly, in case number 2 also we can do. Case 2 is also same. In case 2 we will be substituting r is equals to 1. In case number 2 we have a is equals to 3q plus r. Here substituting r is equals to 1, what I will get? A is equals to 3q plus 1, isn't it? A is equals to 3q plus 1, isn't it? So here I have a is equals to 3q plus 1. Now what he had asked as a square of any positive integer, here I have got only a positive integer, I didn't got square. So for that what I have to do? Squaring on both sides. To convert these integers in square form, I have to square it on both sides. So squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So what I will get? A square is equals to 3q plus 1 whole square. A square is equals to 3q plus 1 whole square. I think you all know the formula of a plus b whole square. Here we will be getting one formula, isn't it? What is that? Since a plus b whole square is equals to a square plus b square plus 2ab, isn't it? A square plus b square plus 2ab. This is the formula. You will be having one song in Telugu. A square b square a plus b whole square, isn't it? So no, here I did some mistake in that. A square plus b square plus 2ab is equals to a plus b whole square. Okay, let it be. We will forget that. It will be coming in our lesson, okay, our chapter. So now for this, here I have two terms. Two are not like terms, they are unlike terms. So because of that reason, I have to use this formula, isn't it? So a square is equals to a square, in the place of a I am taking 3q, in the place of b I am taking 1. So 3q whole square plus b square, or a square plus 2ab plus b square also we can write. If you add 2 plus 3, you'll be getting 5. If you add 5 plus 3 plus 2, you'll be getting again 5, isn't it? So adding front or back, it does not matter. If I take 2ab, so 2 into what is a? 3 cube into what is b? 1 plus b square, that is 1 square, isn't it? So here I'll be getting 3 square, 3 threes are 9, isn't it? So here I am writing 3 into 3 into q square plus 2 into 3 cube into 1 plus 1 square is 1, 1 into 1, isn't it? 1 is multiplied by 1. So here a square is equals to, here I am having divisible as 3. So from where I am getting the 3, I am taking that 3 as common, as the integer is, as the positive integer is divisible by exactly 3. So I am taking 3 common here. So in the bracket I will be getting 1 3 common. So here remaining is 3 cube square plus these 3 I have taken out. So remaining is 2 ones are 2, 2 into cube, 2 cube. So plus 1 will be left outside. Okay. So the thing which is multiplied to 3, I am taking this as p. So the value which is multiplied by 3, I am taking that value as p as shown in the question. So here since 3 q square plus 2 q is equals to, if I take the value that as a p, then I will get k square is equals to 3p plus 1, isn't it? I have got or not? So the a square value, first I have got 3p and second I have got a square value as 3p plus 1. Why I am taking this value? As this whole thing is exactly multiplied by 3, or it is, this whole thing is divisible by 3. Because of that reason, I am taking in single term, that is p. Okay, so you can see from case number 1 and case number 2, if you do case number 3 also, you will be getting the form of 3p. Okay, so this how from case number 1 and case number 2, we can say square of any positive integer. Okay, so we So from case 1 and case 2, we can say that square of any positive integer is of form 3p, 3p plus 1. So square of any positive integer, 3p. Square of any positive integer, that is a square. Positive integer we have taken in a. So here square of positive integer, 3p. Square of positive integer, 3p plus 1. So therefore from case 1, case 2, the square of any positive integer is of the form 3p and 3p plus 1. Okay, so this is how you can solve the problem. If you want to take r is equals to 2, you can take. There, after substituting, you will be getting again 3p form. Isn't it? So you will be getting 3p form. Okay, so this is how you have to solve the problem based upon division algorithm. Okay, so again, you will be having two questions, so you have to do on your own. Okay, so basically I have completed the questions which are important, and other questions are also same, they are related to such type of questions. Okay, so now I am starting, so remaining questions please try to do. Okay, you can do, I think. I know you can. You all can do. Okay. So now we need to know about fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay. Fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Now, coming to fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So, I have already discussed about these in previous class. So, let me introduce one more time. Let me explain you one more time. Okay. So, if I ask you find the prime factors of 35. So, how you will write the prime factors of 35? You will be writing by using prime factorization method, isn't it? Prime factorization method. What is the prime factorization method? The prime factorization method is a method, okay, in which you are finding the prime factors of composite numbers or prime numbers. Okay, it means indirectly I am telling about numbers. Okay, so here I will be starting from 2. It is not divisible by 2. 3, no. 4, no. 5, yes, it is divisible. 5 sevens are 35. Again, I am getting 7 ones are 7. So, what are the prime factors of 35? 5 into 7 into 1. Isn't it? Prime factors of 35 are 5 into 7 into 1. Isn't it? No, absolutely not. 5 and 7 are the prime factors of 35, but not 1. 1 is neither prime nor composite. We can write 5 into 7 into 1. Why? Because 35 ones are, it will again become 35. But 1 is not a prime number, neither it is a prime number, nor it is a composite number. We can't say 1 and neither it is a prime, nor it is a composite number. It is not a prime, not a composite number. So the prime factors are 5 and 7, isn't it? Now if I multiply these prime factors, again I am getting composite number, isn't it? Have told you about prime. And what is a prime? The numbers which are divisible by 1 and itself are called as prime numbers. The numbers which are divisible by, okay, or the number which has more than 2 factors are called as composite numbers. Okay, here the 35 is divisible by both 5 and 7, isn't it? It means that 5 is a factor of 35 and also 7 is a factor of 35, isn't it? See here, we can tell in both the ways. 35 is divisible by 5, yes. 35 is also divisible by 7, yes. What about indirectly? If I tell indirectly, if I ask you one question, okay, Ramu and Ravi. Ramu and Ravi. Ravi is son, Ramu is father. Ravi is son, no. Ramu is son and Ravi is father. Okay, so Ramu is the son of Ravi and Ravi is the father of Ramu. Is there a difference between them? Okay, pronunciation. First, if we take Ramu, then we call Ramu is the son of Ravi. If we start from Ravi, Ravi is the father of Ramu. Okay, okay. The condition will be same, but if the person comes first, then our pronunciation will be little bit different. Father will be coming first, son will be coming at end. In other case, son will be coming first, father will be coming at end. In this case also, 35 is composite, 5 and 7 are prime number. 35 is divisible by 5, 35 is divisible by 7. And if I say reverse, 5 is the factor of 35 and 7 is the factor of 35. Understood? Okay, 35 is divisible by 5, 35 is divisible by 7, but 5 is the factor of 35 and 7 is a factor of 35. If we tell in straight form or reverse form, the meaning is same. Okay, just we are using divisible and factor, the word especially, isn't it? So here, what I did, these composite numbers I have written in form of product of prime numbers, isn't it? I have found the factors in prime form, that is, I have found the prime factors of the number, and whenever I, in a form of product, isn't it? And whenever I form the product, then again I will be getting the same number. So this thing is nothing but fundamental theorem of arithmetic. If I give you definition, what I call each and every composite number can be written as, okay, each and every composite number can be written in the form of product of prime numbers, in a form of product of prime numbers. So this is the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Okay, I think you have all got the definition of fundamental theorem of arithmetic, isn't it? Now coming to other thing, I'm just asking few tables to you. If I ask 10, if I ask you to find the prime factors of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay, here I have given you 5 questions, and here if I ask 5, 15, okay, 25, 35, 45. What is common in these both the numbers? The numbers are not same. Here we have 5 numbers, in group B we have 5 numbers. here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, here 5, 15, 25, 35, 45. The common difference between these numbers is 10, 10 plus 10, 20, 20 plus 10, 30, 30 plus 10, 40, 40 plus 10, 50. Here 5 plus 10, here also common difference is 10, isn't it? 5 plus 10, 15, 15 plus 10, 25, 25 plus 10, 35, 35 plus 10, 45. It means that common thing in these both is, common difference between these numbers are 10, 10, isn't it? Isn't it? So now coming to the point, what I am going to tell you. Now I want you all to tell the prime factors of these all the numbers. If I ask you what are the prime factors of 10, what you will tell? Prime factors of 10 will be starting from 2, 2 5s are 10, 5 1s are 5. So here I have got prime factors as 2 into 5. Again if I take 20, isn't it? 2 10s are 20, again I will be getting 2 5s are 10, again I will be getting 5 1s are 5. So here I have got 2 into 2 into 5. 2 is multiplied by 2 is multiplied by 5, isn't it? If I take for 30, I'll be starting from 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10, 2 15s are 30. If I take from 3, 3, 3 5s are 15, again 5 1s are 5. So here I'll be getting 2 into 3 into 5. Similarly, if I take 40, okay, 40, 40, 2 20s are, 2 10s are, 2 5s are, okay, 5 1s are. Isn't it? So here 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 I have got. So 3 2s into 1 5. Isn't it? If I take 50, 2 25s are. Okay? 2 25s are. 5 5s are. 5 1s are. So here I will be having 2 into 5 into 5. Isn't it? So this is how I will find the prime factors. So again, if I am finding the prime factors for this, so here directly I'll be having 5, here I'll be having 3 into 5, isn't it? For 25 I'll be having 5 into 5, 5 into 5. For 35, 5 7s are 35, 5 into 7. For 45 I'll be having 3 1s are, 3 5s are, 3 5s are, 5 1s are, so 3 into 3 into 5. So this is how I will find the prime factors of the given number. So this how I have found the prime factors of the number. So you can see it clearly. Okay. So you can see here in units place, the these numbers are ending with the digits 0. Isn't it? Whenever these numbers are ending with the digits 0, compulsorily I will be getting prime factors as 5 and 2. Am I right? 5 and 2. Okay. Whenever any number is ending with a 0, any number you can take, any number when it is ending with a 0, that number consists of prime factors as 2 and 5 compulsorily. You can take any number. Any number which is ending with it is 0. If you take 990, whenever you find all the prime factors, you will be getting compulsorily the product as 2 and 5 as prime factors compulsorily. Understood? And whenever the number is ending with 5, is there any common thing in these all? In these all, you will be getting 5. 5. You will be all getting 5. And remaining nothing I can take as common. Here I am getting 3, here I am getting 7, here 5, here a 3, here I am not getting anything, isn't it? So basic thing is this. You have to remember this thing. Whenever the number is ending with a 0, it means that the prime factors, in the prime factors of these numbers, there exist 2 and 5, isn't it? 2 and 5 are compulsorily existing in that numbers. Okay, if such, and now I have given 3 3s are 0, 3 1s are 0. If I take 2 table, 2 from 2 table 2 5s are 10, 2 5s are 10, 5 elevens are 11, 1s are, so compulsory we will be getting 2 and 5. As any number which is ending with the digit 0, any number which is ending with the digit 0, there exist 2 and 5 in their prime factors. Okay, 2 and 5 compulsorily exist in their prime factors. If I give the number 225, okay, 225, there exist 5 but not 2. Why? It is not exiting, it is not ending with the digit 0. Understood? So whenever the number which is ending with 0, it consists compulsorily both the numbers, that is in the prime factors, that is 2 and 5. Understood? So this thing you have to remember compulsorily. Why? Because our next example is depending upon this only. Okay, our next example. What is the next example? Example number 3. So example number 3, consider the numbers of the form, example 3, consider the numbers of the form, 4 power m, where n is a natural number. Check whether there is any value of n for which 4 power n ends with 0. 4 power n ends with 0. Okay, here you can see the question, consider the numbers of the form 4 power n, where n is a natural number. Check whether there is any value of n for which 4 power n ends with 0. Okay, so till now I have given you some examples which are ending with 0. Okay, depending upon that, you have to check whether 4 power n ends with the digit 0 or not. So here we are having lots of methods. In that we are having two methods very important. In that we will be selecting only one method. I will be telling you both the methods in next class. So in that, which one is a very important method, we will be following that. Okay, so depending upon our last examples, we have to follow such solution. Okay, thank you.